Today I'm going to show you how to take apart the Galaxy S6 Edge Plus. It is the bigger and older brother to the Galaxy S6 Edge. To do this repair, you'll need a giant suction cup. I'm just using a window mount and a heat gun. You'll use the heat gun to take off the back plate. Make sure everything is turned off on the phone. Make sure the SIM card tray is out of the phone. And then heat up the back of the phone. Make sure you heat up the top, the bottom, and the middle uniformly all the way around the outside. You want to get the phone so it's too hot to touch with your fingers. What we're doing here is we're warming up the adhesive underneath the phone so that it will be easier to pry off. Grab my suction cup and kind of lift up along the center there and put my metal pry tool in between the glass and the frame, and then I can slide my playing card in between the glass and the frame so that it won't reseal back down once I take my metal pry tool out. I would recommend a flat metal tool for this. If you use something thicker like a razor blade, it will crack the glass. I have done that before. Once you're underneath the glass, make sure to heat it back up again so that the adhesive is still loose, and you can take your pry tool and slide it all the way around the outside and cut away the adhesive. The adhesive is, you know, just inside that half inch all the way around the edge. Now this is much harder than it looks. This video is sped up to not take up too much time. So I would recommend taking your time and making sure not to crack that back glass, especially if you're planning on reusing it after your repair is over. Once that back is off, you can see the old adhesive right around the edge of the back glass. I will put replacement parts down in the video description. I'll do a quick camera lens replacement, so you can just put your razor blade or pry tool underneath that little groove and pop up the lens. The lens will come in two parts, the metal frame and the clear glass. You can just take the clear glass from your replacement lens, pop it in the metal frame, and then take that metal frame and put it back down on top of the camera. Make sure there is no dust or glass shards or anything inside of the camera, and make sure not to touch the inside of the camera lens. There are a bunch of screws around the inside of the phone, so take your Phillips head screwdriver. I will link tools and parts down in the video description below. Once the screws are out, the back will just lift off from the frame. And you can see here the QI charging pad has a bunch of little connections that'll just rest up against the motherboard. Same with the side buttons, the power button, the volume buttons, and then down here for the speaker as well. They just have little contact pads that get their communication when they're pressed up against little pins on the motherboard. Here's the battery connection. I take that off first so I don't have any electricity coursing through the motherboard. And there's two wire cables down at the bottom that are just going to unsnap and pop off. Here's the LCD ribbon cable. Here is the proximity sensors. Going to lift that up and away from the motherboard. And then the motherboard will lift up and fold up, and then there's one more cable down there at the very bottom that we're going to take off, and that is for the charging port. Now that the motherboard's up, we can take off the earpiece, the front-facing camera, and the rear-facing camera. All of these parts are replaceable, which is very nice, except for the SIM card tray that is soldered onto the main board. Here's the 16-megapixel rear camera and the 5-megapixel front camera. Now here's the charging port that I'm fairly disappointed in. You can pop up that fingerprint scanner and get that one little screw off from the charging port, and then there's the two ribbon cables as well. You think you're good to go, but you're not. There are two little wires that are holding the back button and menu button, and they are pinched between the glass and the plastic frame, securely holding the charging port to the phone. It is irreplaceable unless you're some kind of wizard. Now to take out the battery of the phone, I am heating it up so I can pry it out away from the plastic frame. I did not check to see if there was any pull tabs down at the bottom of the battery so that you can pull the adhesive out. Motorola's kind of switching to that. So before you start prying away at your battery, make sure there's no pull tabs down there at the bottom. Check comments, I'm sure other people will have tried this as well. I am taking a metal pry tool and just sliding it in between the plastic frame and the battery. Make sure you don't do any slicing motions though, because you can puncture the battery, making it unusable. So be very, very careful when you're prying that out from the phone. Also make sure not to bend the screen. You don't want to crack the LCD on accident when you're replacing the battery. So here is the charging port that is pinched between the plastic frame and the glass. It is pretty much irreplaceable. It is very, very similar to the Galaxy Note 5. You can click that video and watch how I replace the charging port on that phone. But with the curved screen of the Galaxy S6 Edge Plus, I would say it's almost impossible to pull off the LCD from the plastic frame without breaking it. I am not going to attempt it on my phone, but between this video and my Note 5 video, you should be able to see everything that needs to be done in order to attempt the repair yourself. Go ahead and clip those cameras back into the motherboard, and then clip that charging port down onto the base of the motherboard. Here is the earpiece speaker, going to clip that down. They're just like little Legos. Position it right above the connector and push it down. Here is the LCD ribbon cable and the battery. I'm plugging the battery in last just because we don't want electricity coursing through the motherboard when we're unplugging stuff. Here is the back of the phone. Gonna place that down and get all the screws back into place. and the back glass. Your replacement back glass should have adhesive of its own if you're buying a new one. If you're reinstalling your old one, you can use double-sided tape. I will link that down in the video description as well. And you're good to go. If you have any questions, make sure to leave them in the comments. Don't forget to like if this video helped you. If you did end up taking apart the phone yourself, make sure to leave your experience in the comments. I'm sure it will help out more people in the future. Thanks again for watching, and check out some of my other videos. Hope to see you around.